Have you ever wanted to manage your traffic based on network applications? Making routing decisions based on the first packet coming through the firewall is now a reality thanks to application-based policies and routing. Hi, I'm Aurore, and this is Clavister Tech Talk Series. Today, we're talking about application-based policies and routing in NetWall, and here to tell us everything about it is Matthias Nordlund, our product manager.
Application-based routing, as it states in the name, is a way of routing based on applications. And for us, that means application that we can identify. So of course, it's not on maybe on the application you have installed in your phone or on your, let's say, on your desktop computer. So it's not based on routing things like Word, because that's an application, but network-based applications.
So Matthias, how can you show us how to configure this feature in NetWall?
Yeah. So it's configured on the policies. So in the normal, let's say, IP rule set in NetWall, maybe I want to send Google somewhere, Google traffic. This is a question we usually get. I mean, can I route based on Gmail or on YouTube or on Google Suite? No, it's not possible because there is no way of seeing the difference between all the Google applications, so to say. So we do detect application on the first packet being sent for the firewall. And this is done on, I would say, on two different ways. One is where we use, let's say, well-known IP addresses that belong to Google. So that hits directly and we send the traffic correctly. If we don't already know that it's a Google, let's say, traffic, then the first time it goes through the firewall, it's identified as Google. Then it's added to a cache. So the next time someone goes to the same type of, let's say, application or combination, then it will be routed according to the policy. And also these IPs that are well known, they get updated periodically.
So more of an anecdote than a question, but when I talked to Jonas, who explained the feature to me, he said that the coding time was actually quite short, but the discussion and the design of the feature was what actually took very long.
Mainly because we wanted to make this as easy and understandable to configure as possible. Clavister has a bit of a reputation of being a bit tricky to configure. So we actually went through quite a few prototypes where we tried different ways of configuring it, had beta testers testing it out, and then finally decided on this. That's the main reason. So, and also there were quite a lot of discussion on which applications should we add. That for some reason took a few meetings.
Do we have any customers that already use this feature or want to? And what kind of use case do they have?
Yeah, that's a very good question. That's the most typical use case today is SD-WAN users that if you imagine that you have a hub and spoke network where there's a central firewall in the middle, from the hubs, customers can send all their hub traffic to the central firewall, the hub. And if you do this, you probably don't want to send all this heavy bandwidth content also to the hub, because it consumes resources to, for example, send Windows update traffic to a central place over a VPN link. So one path to internet would be the VPN link, the SD-WAN link, and the second path would be just your default ISP. So you send the bandwidth hungry content directly to the ISP and only send what's important into the SD-WAN hub. By doing that, you reduce the traffic.
Anything else you want to say about the feature or the how customers have perceived it so far?
The customer feedback is good so far, and we're going to maintain this and add applications even more, so it's going to be even more flexible in the future.
We are looking into how can we, let's say, make the routing decisions better. We want to make it simpler to have maybe failover between two different links, mm-hmm. and maybe have more monitoring possibilities. Let's say a video call like this, maybe you want that over the fastest link possible. So how can we simplify for an administrator to configure that it will always select the fastest route? So that's what we are looking into the future when it comes to this, let's say, area of features.
This feature has been released at the beginning of December 2022, and you can get it in NetWall from version 14.007. If you have any comments or questions about this feature or how to use it, please leave a comment below or contact our support at clavister.com/support. Or maybe tell us what you would like us to cover in a future video. And if you learned something today and want to be notified of future episodes, don't forget to subscribe. We'll have one ready for you every month. Thank you for watching and stay safe.